Hi guys, welcome back to another tutorial video. In this video, I'm going to show you how I edit my photo, how to get a dark, moody, cinematic, dramatic look on your photo without any resets and styles. So here's the preview. Okay, so I'm going to use Capture One Express, which is a free editing software that you can download. And I'll put the link to download all the photos that I'll be using in this video in the description. Okay, so without any further ado, let's open up Capture One Express and get started. So first, I will edit this photo that was taken last year. Okay, I will make it looks more dramatic and cinematic. Okay, so let's go to exposure. Here I will bring up the contrast, then bring down the highlight so we can see the details of the sky. Bring up the shadow to around 24, then bring down the white just a little bit and dark. Okay, then I will apply S curve. Then go to color and I will make it more yellows and more purple. Then go to color editor, and for the red color I will reduce the saturation and bring up the lightness just a little bit and the hue so it looks more orange. Then for orange, bring down the saturation as well. And for yellow as well. Then go to details. I always apply the clarity, so just a bit, not too much. Lastly, go to lens and apply fake netting. Okay, so as you can see, now it looks more dramatic. If it's too dark, you can bring up the exposure or bring it down. I will increase the saturation. So this is the before and after. As you can see, now it looks more dramatic. And you can also make it as your preset as well. Okay, so I will copy it and apply it to other photo. Okay, so let's try it on this photo. As you can see, now this photo looks more dramatic as well. I'll bring down the exposure. And this one the same. Let's try this one as well. Okay, yeah, it's just too red. And this one as well. Okay, as you can see, so now you can make your own preset using these settings. So let's edit another photo. I will show you another example. I will edit this one. I will crop it first because there's this lady below. So let's make it looks more dramatic as well. Just like before, bring up the contrast. And for the exposure, we can save it last. Then highlights and bring up shadow. Bring down white and black as well. Then apply the S curve shape. Go to color. So basically, it's just like before. You just need to match the color, not too much. Okay. Set the luminance to 50, color as well, and lastly the clarity. Oh yeah, and thickness, don't forget about it. Okay, as you can see, this is before and after. Now it looks much more better and dramatic. Okay, let's try another one. So this video is just about the process of me editing a photo. Okay, I just took these photos recently. Let's edit this one. Just like before. You can just copy and paste it, but I like to start from scratch. So yeah. Simple. This is before and after because the background is simple as well. What we are lacking in this is we don't have split toning in Capture Express, as you can see, but we can also get a great result without it, so it's fine. And lastly, let's try landscape. Okay, how about this photo? Okay, this one. So I will try to make it as moody, dramatic, and cinematic as I can. Let's try to bring down the highlight and bring up the shadow. I think I need to bring up the exposure. Okay, let's try the brightness. I'll bring up the exposure later. So next, apply the S curve shape. And then the color, I'll make it more warm. And then for this one, apply clarity as well, but not too much, remember. And lastly, thickening. Okay, I will bring up the highlights. Oh, that's too much. Okay, as you can see, I have the sky is overexposed. I have lost the details, but that's fine. So this before and after. Now this one as well looks more dramatic. Okay, like I said before, What we're lacking in this is we don't have split toning feature in Capture One Express, okay? Because this is a free version, but you can try the pro version if you want to use it. So this is what I basically do if I want to get a dark, moody, cinematic, dramatic look for my photos. I usually do these adjustments in Capture One Express. And after that, sometimes I go to Affinity Photo and do some more adjustments, like change the sky and apply some more adjustments, something like that. Okay, so that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed and learned something new from this video. Hit the like button if you like this video. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. And I'll see you guys in the next video.